Hello everybody, this is Mr. Fire, and here we have a very special build. This build is very special because it relies on a very special set of items. The set of items is this one here. It is the Agent of the Order. So, this is a build which I call the Prometheus Gift build, because this build was supposed to be relying on this set, the Agent of the Order. The Agent of the Order is a reference to the Prometheus Order, which exists in this game, and it exists in the form of NPCs. In some places in the world of the game, mostly we could say in Act 1 and Act 2, the first two acts mostly, and also in Act 3 a little bit, we can see that there are some NPCs that use, they have equipped these items. Or at least some of these items. They have the mage robes and maybe the shield or the helmet or something like that. So yeah, these people, they belong to the Prometheus Order in the game. Of course, some of these NPCs are irrelevant. You just talk to them and you talk to them. This is it. But there are a couple of more that you turn in quests to them. When you turn in quests to those NPCs that were this armor, for example, there is a small chance as a reward to get from them these items. This is why this is a special build, because this set of items is a special set of items. I call it special myself, because the only way to get these items is by getting these items as rewards from these NPCs. Of course, to do that, you have to be super lucky, because it is not a reward they give very easily, it is a rare reward. And I have played so many times through the campaign, I have talked to those guys so many times, and I have found only a very few times I have gotten these items as reward from them. So yeah, if you got to complete the full set, you have to play at least normal difficulty many times, multiple times, complete all of the quests that will give you rewards from these specific NPCs. And if you do this, and if you are lucky enough, you will get as rewards these items. This is the special part of the set. So, after I gathered all of the items from the rewards, I thought, okay, it is time for me to make a special build based on this set and go through the game. And here we are. This is normal difficulty, because the set itself is not a powerful one. It is a very low level set. For normal difficulty, it is a very nice set. It is okay. It is nothing special. It is okay. It works fine. Even in Ragnarok Act, it works fine. Or even in Atlantis. Okay. Ragnarok Act provides more challenge than Atlantis Act, because the damage numbers that come from Atlantis enemies and bosses and whatnot, they are equivalent to the damage of Hades Act, not Ragnarok. Ragnarok comes after Hades, and this is why Ragnarok is the toughest act when it comes to damage numbers and all of these things. Even in Ragnarok, in normal difficulty, this set is good enough. But it is good enough if you combine it with some other very nice items, of course. So, here we are in this build. This is the build. My goal with this build is, I have already finished normal difficulty, everything. Let me see, have I played Atlantis? I don't remember. No. Because in normal Atlantis is a bit pointless. But, this is my goal now. My plan now is to take all of these 5 items that belong to the set, take them and upgrade all of the items with the upgrade quest of Ragnarok Act. But upgrade them with the legendary tier of the upgrade, which means I will have to go to legendary difficulty and upgrade the items. To do that, I'm not going to use any exploits. I'm going to use my other the upgrades that I haven't used from older characters of mine, other characters of mine, of legendary difficulty only. I will use those legendary upgrades on all of these items, one upgrade per item, and then after I have upgraded all of these items, I will take this character for one more journey, this time through epic difficulty. Epic difficulty is going to be the end game of this build, because you know, even if I upgrade these items in legendary difficulty, the items will not become that good to go in legendary difficulty and have a good time there. It is going to be super duper super challenging in legendary with this set. And actually, the game is going to become very frustrating in legendary. So, the goal is to play at least epic and complete the build and finish the journey of the build in epic difficulty, which I will do in the future. For now, this is what we have. Let's see. Let's talk about the skills. I decided to go with Stone Speaker class, which is Earth Mastery and Rune Mastery. In Earth Mastery, we can see the setup of my skills. I play with Earth Enchantment and these two add-ons. I have Volatility, I have the Heat Shield, I have these two skills, some points here. This is it in normal difficulty. This is the state of my Earth Mastery at level 32 Mastery. In Rune Mastery, we are at level 24. I play with Rune Weapon with the two add-ons. This is very powerful, this is very important. I decided to go with Rune Mastery because the more you attack with Runic Weapon, the more it increases your total damage and also elemental damage and intelligence points, which is super duper awesome, because now with this skill here, this item provides a very small amount of damage, as we can see. But with the Runic Weapon, we can see that now this skill deals lots of damage, because it also this weapon, that skill, this weapon with that skill, because this one has a chance for one of the following, which is fire damage, cold and lightning damage. These three always trigger every time we attack an enemy. One of these three stats will trigger, but they always trigger. One of these will always trigger. So yeah, now if you have this one triggering all the time, and at the same time you have on top of that this very small amount of physical damage, and you get from this one total damage for each one of the attacks that you do with Rune Weapon, total damage, elemental damage, and also more intelligence points, which increases even further your elemental damage and vitality damage, then this means that now, at least in normal difficulty, we deal a very good amount of damage with this one, and everything is fine. So, this is why I decided to go with Rune, mostly because of this skill. This is also awesome because it provides more elemental damage, flat elemental damage to these attacks, and also it provides elemental retaliation, so when melee attackers hit you, they receive elemental damage from this one. And it is a very nice combination for this build. I have only 2 points here. Later I will probably put 1 point at least on this one. I have maxed out this one because it is very nice to have. It provides also offensive ability, which we need because we play a melee build. I have spent only 1 point here and 1 point here and 1 point here. In the future I will spend more points here. I have maxed out this one 10 out of 10 and this one only 1 point, and I have maxed out of course this one. This is the state of the skills and it works pretty much fine. Now, when it comes to the attributes, we can see that I have spent points in many different attributes. The only attributes I haven't spent points on are health and energy. We have points on strength, points on intelligence, points on dexterity. Why? Because we can see that these items have different requirements of attributes. This one has strength, intelligence. This one has intelligence only. Strength, intelligence. Intelligence, dexterity, strength, intelligence. So yeah, I had to increase both strength and intelligence, and of course I spent points on dexterity because this is always useful in this game. Yeah, these are my attributes. As we can see, resistance is 80%, 80%, 53, 0. For normal difficulty, my resistances are very good, and also I get 26% physical. The combined armor, of course, is not good. This is very bad, even in normal. But anyway, I survived sometimes. I have gotten killed 5 times overall, which is okay if you think about it, especially for a build that uses so bad items when it comes to defenses and armor. But anyway, what can you do? This was always going to be a very challenging playthrough. My star resistance is okay. We have freeze resistance, sleep, petrification and trap. For the items, I have been using the set as we said before, which is this item. It consists of the Edai Magic Robes, the Arcane Purifier, the Titan Watch Helm, very nice helm, with the Skill Study Prey, the Seal of the Vigilant Shield, and the Prometheus Greaves. So, we can see that with this set we get some buffs to attributes mostly, and also 40% attack speed, which is super duper awesome. And we don't get many, you know, with the bonuses of the set, they don't provide any resistances. And this is not very good, of course. But anyway, what can you do? As we said before, this is a challenging set. Now, the rest of my items are Shroud of Eternal Night. This is one of the best lesser artifacts for normal difficulty only. It is very good, very good. We have Timaeus and we have Valky. These two provide some very nice bonuses and of course some very nice and important attributes. Strength requirement for weapons, strength which increases physical damage, health points, plus 3 to battle awareness, which is useless to us because we don't play with defense mastery. Here we have the Clasp of the Mothers, a nice item for normal difficulty. Actually, it is very nice because of the resistances it provides and also health and recharge reduction. And the skill is super awesome. Health, activated on low health, it heals you back at the fullest. And it is awesome because it can keep you alive sometimes. And here we have the Prismatic Necklace of Dexterity. This is also a very awesome item for normal difficulty because it provides elemental resistance, some damage reflection, elemental damage when we attack with weapons, dexterity. And I decided to go with the Dionysus Wineskin Embodiment one because this one provides more health and some physical resistance. And yeah, this is a build. The build actually with the Stone Speaker class is amazing. It feels very nice to play with this build. It is very satisfying. We have attack speed 134%. We have movement speed 124%. And it is very nice. Let's kill a couple of enemies here. Let's see, what can we do? We activate this one, we activate these two skills, of course. We can see that we lose some energy because I have this one active, but this is very energy costly and we lose energy. But anyway, what can you do? Sometimes we gain energy back when enemies hit us and they hit us with energy attacks, spells, whatever. We can see here, this is the end of normal difficulty. Yeah, since we are here, let's go and do this boss fight. I have only 5 health potions, maybe I should go and buy some health potions. We can see that we destroy these giants pretty fast. No problems here whatsoever. Very nice. I'm going to buy a couple of potions because this is not a good idea to go to the boss without potions. Here we are, I have 43 potions now. Let's see what can we do against this boss. This boss is stunning me all the time. Come on. We can see that we receive a good amount of damage from these attacks of this boss because our armor is very bad. But we can also deal good damage against that boss, so the boss will get hit without killing us. The boss is almost down. Yeah, the boss is dead. So, this is the final boss of normal difficulty campaign. We just got the fine Golic boots as a reward from the boss, the orb of the boss. So, we can see that at least in that place, the build is very good at that point in normal difficulty. As we can see, it is very, very good. In epic difficulty, the things are going to be tougher, but first I will go and I will upgrade all of these 5 items with the legendary tier, and then I will start playing epic difficulty. And of course, after I complete epic difficulty, I will have an update video for build guide video for this build to let you know in epic difficulty how this build with this set equipped can perform after we have upgraded all of these 5 sets with the legendary tier of the upgrade. So everybody, this is the build. Maybe sometimes I will play with this build on live streams. If you want me to do so, let me know in the comments below, and I will do it if you got me. Why not? The build is awesome. It looks awesome, by the way. These items look fantastic. Some of the best looking items in this game, I would say, and if not the best looking items. And yeah, maybe in tomorrow's live stream I will live stream this build if you got me to do so. Let me know. So everybody, thanks for watching this video. Have fun whatever you do, and I'll be back tomorrow with a new live stream.